Let's look at how you can use the logic in Python code. We're going to start off more logic part two with the code. Once you think you understand the concepts and the code, try it out with some practice. Let's look at the code. For choice, we can use if else with elif in between. So here, if positive, print plus, elif negative, print minus, else print zero. So instead of having just if and else, we can have another if statement in between, and we use elif. We can change that. If my number is greater than zero, print plus. Elif my number is less than zero, print minus. Else print my number is zero. Equals, which has the one equal sign, and equals. My number equals 7. If my number equals 7, print 7. There's a difference. The first one is assigning the value 7 to the variable my number. So now my number equals 7. In the second example, in the if statement, we're checking, does the variable my number have the value 7? First one, make my number be 7, and the second one, is it the same as the value 7? So in the if statement, instead of using greater than or less than, if you want to check if something's the same, you can use two equal signs, not one, two. If 1, 2, 3, 4, coffee, tea, water, juice. In code, we have the if statement, so we could have if my number equals 1, is the same as 1, print coffee, same as 2, print tea, same as 3, print water, the same as 4, print juice. We've got if, elif, elif, elif. So we only have one if at the start. Any other ifs, if you like, after, are changed to elif. If you want to use an else, that's at the end. In the other example, small, normal, large, extra large. So we can use if, elif, elif, elif again, the same. And we can change that. Example, instead of printing, we can just change the variable price to 2, 2.5, 3, and 4, and then just print the price. So that's the same example, but using the variable. We're now going to look at our example using blocks of code. Here we've got if true or false. So it's true, we're going to print line 1, 2, and 3. So we output has line 1, 2, and 3. Can you see how all of the print statements have that space, that indentation? We can see that using that block. They're all part of the same code. Here's an example where we're going to look where there is that space and where there's not that space. So here we have print line 1 inside the if statement. So it prints line 1. Print the end has no space in front of it, so it's always going to do that. Do you remember our red block when we had to go past it? Yeah. So this prints line 1 if the if statement is true. It doesn't print line 1 if it's false. But it always prints the end. You can see the block. So here it's false, but print the end will always happen. We can see the block there. Remember when we moved the red block with the blue block? They were together. Here, if true or false is true, it will do both. But in this example, it's false. So line 1 and the end, they're part of the if statement, which is not true. So there is no output in this example. So you can see the block of code there. If you have the space and if you don't have the space, it's very different. Now let's look at the nested if statement, the if inside another if. So here, can you remember our example when we bought fruit? Here's our block, and remember we only get change if there is change. Let's see that in code. If by fruit, we've got the first print, the second print, then we've got another if statement, and then we've got the indentation, receive change, and then we go back. So take fruit is part of the first if statement, not the second nested if change statement. If there's no change, we would print choose fruit, pay money, and take fruit. The example of first day of the month, you can see the first block, the first indentation, and then the if else part. So if we look at the code, it's nearly identical, and we have here if month equals equals Jan, happy new year, else new month, if it's the first day of the month. Your turn with some practice. Let's look to code our example of a menu with three buttons. Write an if, elif, else statement to print A, B or C when either of the buttons 1, 2 or 3 are selected. Here's an example where we have three colours and the colours repeated, one where they're dark and one where they're light. So we're going to have a choice of these six colours, if you like. Blue, red and green. Three of them dark, three of them light. So we're going to do it in four parts. The first part, write an if-else statement where it will print red or blue. Now you can choose the condition. We're going to use if number is greater than zero. So that's part one. Part two, write another if-else statement. This time we're going to print dark or light. So if num2 is greater than 0, then print dark or print light. Part 3. Put the first if-else statement inside the second. So now you can print either dark red or dark blue, if it's dark, or light red or light blue, if it's light. Finally, part 4. Write an else part to your nested if else statement. So now you can print either dark red, dark blue or dark green, or light red, light blue or light green. Good luck with those tasks. If you need to go back and look at them again, please do so. Make sure you understand them and try to code them and come back to check with the video. Okay, let's go through the answers. We started off with an if, elif, else statement. We're going to print A, B or C if we have the buttons 1, 2 or 3. So we have just an if, elif, and we've used the example of a third elif where we have if button equals, using equals equals, 1, print A, 2, B, 3, C. This example we had six options and embedded, so we have an if, elif, else embedded in an if else, so quite complicated. So part one, we just had an if else statement. If number is greater than zero, print red, else print blue. Part two was pretty much the same, except for print dark and print light if number two was greater than zero. Part 3, we're going to put that second one inside the first. So we have if number is greater than 0, print red, else print blue. But now we're going to add dark to that. If num2 is greater than 0, else light red and light blue. If number is greater than 0, print light red, else print light blue. So we can see here we've got the nested if else, and the top is if it's dark, else, and the bottom if it's light. Part four, we're just going to add an else part, so we're going to have an if, an elif, and an else inside the nested part. So at the top we've got the num2 is greater than 0, so it's going to be dark. So we've got if num greater than 0, print dark red, elif, print dark blue, else print dark green. We're going to finish with some terms. Remember the space at the beginning of the line, what we can put as blocks, that is the indentation. We've added the elif statement, which is the same as an if statement, but it's not the first one. An if inside another one is called a nested if. And remember, we can use not as well. Remember the example, pay or not pay. Okay, we've come to the end. Please like and share, hit the bell, and if you haven't already, subscribe. If you've got any questions, please add a comment below. Thank you for watching the video. Goodbye for now.